All right, so the new GRE is coming soon, and there's lots of stuff you need to know if you're going to be ready for it. First off, it's an hour longer than before, so mental stamina is going to be more important than ever. Next, scoring. Gone is the 1600. Now the total is out of 340. Now if the test is longer, what's that going to mean? Well, you're going to have more of each section. Two math, two verbal, versus the old one for each section. Plus, there's also going to be an experimental section. Don't try to guess it. Do your best on each. Now, for the actual test experience, we have a section-by-section adaptation, meaning how well you do in one section determines the next section you get. This is very different from the old GRE, where it adapted within the section. Going back to the new GRE, you're going to be able to skip between questions in a section. This, of course, differed from the sequential order of the last GRE. And on the math section, there are going to be some changes as well. Increased focus on statistics, as well as coordinate geometry. So know your parabolas. For those higher scores, well, time for the quadratic equation. Make sure you know that. Scary? Well, good news. You get to use a calculator on this GRE. It looks like it'll look exactly like that on the screen. So, important things to know. Most important thing, transfer display. That is, the answer in that box will be transferred into the answer box. Which answer box? Well, good question. New question type is numeric entry, where there will be an answer box. Transfer that from your calculator or enter it yourself. And let's have an example right here. I'll tell you the answer. It's 99. Where'd you put it? In the box. There's your answer. Another question type, multiple answer questions. Select one or more. So there are going to be a bunch of choices. Anyone that applies to the example. Let's look here. The answer is going to be negative 15 all the way down here to answer choice I. So it's important to note that you must select all that apply or you will get no credit. And the changes coming to the verbal section. Well, remember the analogies and antonyms? Well, they're gone. Instead, the new GRE will test your understanding of words in context. New types of questions. First off, sentence equivalence. Select two answer choices. What does a sentence equivalence look like? Here it is. Six answer choices, two of which are correct. What else you have to know? Text completions. Text completions, well, a little bit more complicated. There are two blanks, three answer choices for each blank. One goes in there, one goes in there. Next, changes coming to the reading comprehension. There is passage highlighting. You will have to highlight the passage, highlight the entire sentence to get credit. And then there is also multiple answer questions, where there will always be three answers. Select one, two, or three that apply. On the writing section, you still have two essays. You will have the argument essay, you will have the issue essay, and you will have an hour to do both. They're going to be weighed evenly, and that's different from the old GRE, where you had 45 minutes for the issue. So now that you've gotten all the info you need on the new GRE, how are you going to better prepare for it? Well, there isn't a lot of material out there right now, but Magoosh Test Prep has gotten a head start and we're already stocked with almost 600 practice questions, exactly like the new GRE format. Our basic service is free, so visit newgre.magoosh.com to sign up today. Thanks for watching and good luck with your studies.